Firstly, hello world. As you said, I'm Krešimir Antolić and I'm a JavaScript developer in Finland. And I love the web and I love my job. And today I'm going to talk to you about building an application you have. The thing is, I'm almost the last one in this conference. So I don't want this talk to be intensive. So I'm going to, well, not going to make a talk, I'm just going to make a story of it. So let's start with a boy. A small, simple boy who lives in a village. A small village protected from the world. And let's say the boy is a thinker. So he likes to do stuff. He likes to poke things. When I say poke, I mean computer stuff. So he did C, he did C++, he did Python, he did Java, he did C sharp, he even did PHP. And one day, he knew everything that was to know in that village. Great. So the next logical step is, let's go to the world. So, let's try. But what the kid didn't know, the world is a vast and scary place. The applications that needed to work there were, well, kind of scary. They needed to be run on multiple computers with different OS, multiple browsers, and multiple devices. Well, to be honest, he was scared. And he ran. He ran and he ran until he came to a castle. And in that castle, there lived a mighty king. And he knew he needed to ask the king for help. So this is actually where the real story starts. Oh, mighty king, this world, I do not know. How am I to survive in this? Oh, shit. I need to know it all. Badass and relapse. That's the past. The world needs everything from me. But alas, I feel unsuited for the task ahead. And then, simple number one. It is dangerous to go alone. Please, take this. This will give you the power you need. It's a hammer. I got a hammer. What is this? This is a hammer that will solve all your problems because it bestows the users the power of JavaScript. And that's with the colors of JavaScript. But I know JavaScript. I wrote all kinds of JavaScript applications. This is really more, much more. But I need to write a mobile app. Ah! Use Smash for all. It will give you everything you need. Everything. Build a web app. Just simple web app, as you know. And use the interface Apache Cordova provides. So you don't? Well, Apache Cordova, as you probably know, there was talk yesterday. Christian did it. And it's, well, it's a wrapper that you put on your mobile device. You just go to your business logic JavaScript. You use HTML and CSS for representation, so the UI, and you can use native functionalities of the mobile device by using the provided APIs. And it works on a lot of devices, so it's like iOS, Android, Firefox OS, and even Windows Phone. And a lot more, but I'm not going to get into that. slow, will it look the same? Won't the user notice? It will be good enough. But you can use NativeScript. Well, this is interesting. When it's finished, of course. The authors promise, well, after that, it will provide native elements. Well, you just write JavaScript and you get a native application. So NativeScript is done by Frederick, and the idea is you write a JavaScript application, simple JavaScript, use the interface logic, so it's like we use object that provide base UI elements and create it natively. So you have native elements, JavaScript logic, it works perfectly, but it's not finished. It is expected to be finished by May 2013, so barely that actually. It looks promising. Well, that's great and all, but everything is not mobile. Sometimes I need a desktop application. Then you don't have it. node-webit is great. It's seamless integration of Node.js and JavaScript. It's wonderful. You have all the power you need. You write it in JavaScript, and you use CSS and HTML as you always do in web applications. Well, that's actually the main part I want to say. You use JavaScript for logic again. And you use Node.js for the native functionalities. So Node.js is a server language. So you can have access to files, system, whatever. You have access to the computer that's installed on. Another good thing is you have node-webit has Chromium in it. So you can use all the new features of the web. It always has the newest version on. And it works on Linux and Windows, which is like all the computers. Well, this is great. JavaScript is great. You have all the power you need in this. I feel powerful. And now we start with the Mad King. Yes, yes! You see it now. Feel the power. Feel it. Well, yeah, he's right. This is powerful. Yes, yes. With JavaScript, you can write application logic once and run it everywhere. Huh? Wait. What did that guy just say? JavaScript. Write on once, run everywhere. Hmm. That sounds familiar. That's why. So this was the slogan that Java was, well, let out. Write once, run everywhere. But you don't see Java replacing JavaScript right now. So the developers weren't very satisfied because there were a lot of problems with Java we get to. It's more like write once, debug everywhere, which creation was set on the stock on logical level. Well, Yao, it was supposed to be the chosen one. But, yeah, you know how the movie turned out, so. But the same goes for JavaScript. JavaScript, write once, debug everywhere. Why?
Well, the answer is quite simple, actually. Fragmentation. So we have a lot of browsers. A lot. We have a lot of devices. Okay, we can live in it. But also we have a lot of iOS systems. So multiply that with browsers, multiply that with versions of the browsers, and you get big level of fragmentation. But why is Java field here and JavaScript? Well, actually, it's quite easy. JavaScript is like the force. So it's all around us. Or actually, maybe within you right now. Or actually, not within you, well, it's more like your mobile phones, your computers. And don't forget, all your TVs actually have smartphones. Sorry, I'm sick. So the problem with Java was you have to install it and run it and you have problems. But the JavaScript part is you already have the environment there, out there. So your environment is already with you. So they just push your application and I hope it works. So you start working on a new project. And now we are going to write the JavaScript. Just remember this. Any application that can be written in JavaScript will be written. This is known as Atwood's law. And he made that prediction like, I don't know, 3-4 years ago. And everything's being written in JavaScript now. Well, that's not a good thing, actually. The first thing people ask themselves, can you write JavaScript? No. Yes, we can do everything in JavaScript. But do you really have to do it in JavaScript? Well, probably not. But this is another thing. When doing a project, you're limited with resources. So you have 3 weeks to create a mobile application for iOS, Android, and so on. You're not going to create application because maybe your budget doesn't fit in it. So you're going to use Atwood. Okay, that's reasonable. But if you create a big project and you're going to maintain it for a long time and you want a premium service, maybe you're going to think about the next solution. Maybe. That's up to you to decide. I can't do that. We're just not things. That's not good. That's not good. I mean, do you remember the keynote yesterday for all of you that were there? Well, you probably do. So, is it working to write JavaScript? Yeah, maybe. But reference to the keynote was you had a working ball, and you had a chainsaw, and you had a knife. So you need to have the motor. What are you going to use? As Ross said, use like to for your job. Oh. Think about it. Thanks.
Questions. Thank you. Okay. Thank you.